That's good. Hey there, it's Lynda Cromar, and I'm coming to you from Colorado. And this is the first of many of my backyard chats. And the reason why I put up that little post, the title, I talked about if you take care of the basics, you're almost there. Now, a lot of people don't know what that means. You know, they get so far into debt, they just don't have a clue how to get out of it, and they're just in a big panic. And I think you know who you are. Those are people that are trying to do business, but they're doing it in such a desperate way that it's not working. I've been putting out posts, a lot of posts about just common sense, money situations, because that is so important. I am sitting in my own backyard in a house I've lived in. It's going on 30 years. In just a few days, I will hit my 30th anniversary with my husband, and we've lived in the same place for 30 years. Now, the reason why I bring that out is because that's so important. I'm not in a hurry to go get into another great big house payment. We just got through getting done with doing our reverse mortgage. Well, we're in the process. It's not done. And what we're doing is we're doing that not because we're in a desperate situation. I want to make this clear. It's because we're in a better situation and we want to clear up some of the debt so that we can even be in a better place. And it isn't about business exactly, but it is in a sense, because whatever you do in your personal life, whatever you do with your finances, it all spills out on everything. And people can smell it if you are desperate. And if you're trying so hard to get people to look at something because you just got to have that sale right now. And that is a situation where it just ends up being completely a backfire, and it kills your sales instead of helps your sales, because you can't be in a place of desperation and trying to convince and kill and practically knock people over with your offers, because they're not going to see it for the right reasons. All they're going to see is that you're desperate. So one of the things that I try to teach is that you want to be in a better place. And thanks so much, all of you that have just joined. I appreciate it so much. But you want to be in a much better place. You want to be in a place of looking at where you are. Where can you cut expenses? I know you don't hear that very often, but it's so seriously important. Where can you get rid of the waste? Where can you cut? Where can you make things a little less stressful? And when you do it that way, you're in a better relaxed place. You are not so desperate for a sale that you come across as desperate so that people are actually going to be pushed away. You don't want that. You want people to say, I like that person. They've got a good vibe. They feel comfortable. They feel like a leader. They feel like they've got it all together. If you're in a desperate situation, you don't have it all together, and it's not going to be possible to pretend that you do. Do you get what I'm saying? I hope you do, because it's important. So instead of thinking about the big car you've just got to have, how are you going to, you know, figure out how to fix the one you already have? If you have a house, figure out how to make that house work for a while. Don't get in over your head, because that makes it harder to build the business you want. Learn how to be a little bit more willing to wait for the big things you think you have to have. And if you start to look at it that way, you're more stable, and they're going to be more excited about seeing that you are somebody that they are interested in being part of. Like, for instance, I'm always sharing things about, I use a system called Power Lead System. I'm not selling it today. In fact, I'm very selective who I share it with. The reason why is because I believe it helps people, but I don't need looky-loos. And I don't even want to talk to people that are just curious. And the reason why it's important, it's because I want stability in my business and in my home life. That's why I'm here 30 years instead of trying to find a bigger house, because I think it's going to make a big impression. In the end, it's not going to make a big impression. In the end, people are going to see the difference. People can tell when you're not being real. And I'd rather show you my not so fancy house, but it's paid off. And the bills are almost paid off. I'm going to be debt free in less than 2 years. That's my goal. And I think it should be everybody's goal. And the reason why being is debt kills you. It's not a good thing to be in debt, and it's not a good thing to run out and get the new car that has the huge, like, what, $500 are now charging for people to lease or to buy a car. That's crazy. I'm not going down that road. That's just absolutely crazy. I'm going to pay cash or I'm not going to do it. And that is something that is so very, very important. And I really want you to get this. People like people that are stable. They don't want people that are flighty. And it's important for people to know that you're not, you are stable. You stay in one place. I'm in the same stuff I was in 2 years ago. I'm not changing. I don't have to change. It works for me. And that's how I want to teach others as well. Being stable feels good. You don't have to jump around all the time. You don't have to get the new car. You don't have to get the new TV. You don't have to buy a new house. You can look at what you're doing right now that you can make yourself in a better financial place. If less is going out, you have more to live on. What a novel idea. Yeah, that feels good, doesn't it? To know that you have enough to live on, that you can go buy the foods you need to in the grocery store, that you're not practically starving. Nobody wants to be there. And so I want to share with you that you can get on my marketing list, and that is a good place where I share a lot more of this kind of stuff all the time, because I believe in being wise. You don't have to be crazy and just act on everything that comes along. Think about where you are. Be happy a little bit. I don't mean you have to settle. I'm not settling. I love where I live, actually. And it feels good not to be in a hurry to move, actually. So that's our backyard chat for today. I don't know if it'll be outside every day. It'll depend on the weather. We've had a lot of rain. But I will definitely share my wisdom with you. And if you want to get on my newsletter so that you can learn more from me, that is at marketingnewswithlynda.com. That's marketingnewswithlynda.com. And I will see you probably around the same time again tomorrow. Bye for now.